Coach Newell is a real icon in San Francisco Bay Area basketball. A 1949 NIT championship for USF, a NC2A championship with Cal. Just a real icon in San Francisco basketball.
Basketball legend. I mean, you know, definitely a coaching legend. You know, I grew up hearing the name Pete Newell. You know, the Pete Newell clinics, you know, it's, I mean, you know, you talk basketball, Pete Newell is one of the first coaching names that I think comes to anybody's mind.
My brief conversation with him was like a 5 to 10 minutes in basketball heaven, because you get a chance to talk to a legend, and he's talking about doing it the right way, and it can be done at USF, and you know, best of luck. And so that, to me, that gave me a lot of encouraged me, you know what I mean, especially in my first year when things weren't the easiest, and I knew that we could get it to a...
Well, I'll tell you what, I kind of grew up with a family. Pete Newell Jr. played on the same high school team as I did at St. Ignatius, so I was over the Newell home a number of times, so I can think that Coach Newell was really a mentor of mine throughout my whole career, so that was just a great basketball family.
The first time I ever met Pete Newell was my second or third year calling USF games, and we were playing a road game at San Diego, and I'm pretty sure he was a Southern California resident. He was retired, but he was at the game and in the stands, and I thought, gee, what a great opportunity to grab him for a halftime interview. But at the same time, I was also a little intimidated because I was a young broadcaster. So I walked over, you know, kind of nervously, you know, asking this basketball legend if he would come on the halftime show. He couldn't have been a nicer guy. He's like, you know, no problem. You know, he came over at halftime. He was happy to come on.
I think the biggest thing for me is like, Rex, you can do it there. And you can do it the right way, you know what I mean? And I've been a guy that's always been about trying to do things the right way and recruit the right type of kids, the student athlete. And he encouraged me that it can be done. And I'm talking about this. These are in the dark days. This is the first year, you know what I mean? And I was struggling, and we had really good kids. But just to coach them, Rex, coach them. Believe in what you're doing. Believe in your philosophy. Stay the course, you know what I mean? Things will get better, you know what I mean? And if you work it, that to me, the fact that he even took my call, you know, to me was like a blessing, you know, and he talked to me and tried to, you know, counsel me when he didn't know my name, you know what I mean? We had no relationship before then, and the fact that he would be so gracious and so kind and being a legend. I mean, when people say Pete Newell, your eyes light up, and the fact that he would spend that amount of time with me was truly special for me.
And I think Coach Newell always preached, you know, you could go with change and different offenses and defenses, but he always preached simplicity and execution. And I think everyone mimicked those types of teams in those years, whether it would be a reverse action offense that he used to run or simple position man-to-man defense was really the style of basketball that he taught and really carried over to when I started coaching in high school and then all the way up on the college level.
I mean, you talk about today's world, and there's, you know, the Mike Krzyzewski, certainly, and, you know, Dean Smith and others, but, you know, Pete Newell sort of set the trail, and, you know, a lot of the methods that coaches use today, you know, came from Pete Newell, you know, so I think that speaks something special right there.